Every star we see is a burning mass of plasma, similar to the Sun. Even so, our Sun is not just any old star. 95% of all stars are less massive, and smaller stars are found in abundance. That is a very important consideration. If the Sun was smaller, then the habitable zone for Earth would be much further inward, and that would induce synchronous rotation. The gravity from a small Sun would cause one side of the Earth to continually face the Sun. In other words, there would be no day and night, only boiling temperatures on one side and freezing temperatures on the other. Earth is about 93 million miles from the Sun and is situated in a very narrow band that supports habitability. If the Earth was only 5% closer to the Sun, it would become like the planet Venus, boiling hot and uninhabitable. However, if we were just 20% farther away, our planet would resemble Mars, freezing and still uninhabitable. If Earth was on a very elliptical orbit around the Sun, then it would be alternately too close and too far away for life to be sustained. Instead, we find that Earth has a nearly circular orbit, perfect for life. There can be no doubt that the Earth occupies a favored position, the only known position in which human life can be sustained. It was created with purpose. Thus saith the Lord that created the heavens, God Himself that formed the earth and made it. He hath established it, He created it not in vain, He formed it to be inhabited. Not only that, but God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. I'm David Rives. Truly, the heavens declare the glory of God.
David Rives Ministries presents The Heavens Declare the Glory of God, an exciting one-hour DVD, now available in the WorldNet Daily Superstore. By way of deep sky photography and common sense terminology, the mysteries of the universe unfold in a manner that is easily understood. Great things past finding out, yea, and wonders without number.